Seshadri Chari is back, foreign affairs cell convener of the BJP. He has strong views on this. Dr. Naganathan, founder of youth.org, this debate is getting more and more heated. R. Rajagopal is the senior journalist and he believes that the UPA, the Congress and its allies have been completely hypocritical in their handling of the subject. T.K. Selangoman, member of parliament of the Lok Sabha, represents the DMK point of view. My first question is to Manika Tagore, yes. Congress member of parliament of the Lok Sabha from Tamil Nadu. Mr. Tagore, good evening. I'm afraid my first charge against you will be, not you, your party, is that you lack consistency. You have no position on this issue. You keep changing your position depending on what you think is politically convenient. You have 10 members of parliament. These MPs, including you, did not attend the TESO, Tamil Eelam Supporters Organization conference due to Congress party pressure. After meeting Rahul Gandhi on March 4th, now they have attended this conference. You have no consistency on the Tamil issue. Will you support the LTTE directly or indirectly, knowing fully well that it was the LTTE which killed Rajiv Gandhi?
No, Mr. Anurag, I want to be very clear in one thing. That we, the Tamil Nadu MPs, had in the previous year itself, when we met the Honorable Prime Minister regarding the vote in that time in Geneva in the UNHRC, we pleaded that we should vote against the Sri Lankans, because I am one of those people who had visited with the leader of opposition, Sushma Swaraj, to Sri Lanka when the parliamentary delegation went previous year. And we had seen the agony, the problem, the pain of those people and the projects which the government of India is undertaking there. And with that, previous year when that vote came, we pleaded to the Prime Minister that we should vote against the Sri Lankans. In that time, it was a different position, because first time it was our country stand was being changed to a country-specific resolution was being discussed. And previous year, that has been taken and India voted against Sri Lanka.
Mr. Manik Tagore,
This year.
Okay, complete. I'll let you complete. Yeah.
This year, in the start of the session itself, 22nd of this February, all the Tamil Nadu Congress MPs met the Honorable Prime Minister and told to him that the previous year's resolution has not been implemented by the Sri Lankan authorities.
Now, how have you woken up to this today? I want to ask you, how have you realized today that human rights violations have been carried out on the Tamil Tigers? How have you realized today the Sri Lankan government was wrong? Why did you not realize it a few days back?
No, Mr. Arnab, you have to be little patient. Previous year, 1 year before, when that UNHRC vote was there, in that time itself, India voted with the resolution against the Sri Lankans, 1 year before. Okay? And the 22nd, we told again to the Prime Minister that it is going to be the follow-up of that resolution. This time also, they are not implemented much. And their own LLRC, they are not...
Really? Am I mistaken in understanding? Let's get the facts absolutely clear. If I'm not mistaken, Seshadri Chari, if I'm not mistaken, when Rajapaksa visited India in September 2012, he held meetings with both President Pranab Mukherjee and Prime Minister Manmohan Singh. Why did Manik Tagore and the Congress leaders then not object to his meeting the Congress leadership? Why are you maintaining dual positions? One for center and one for state. Mr. Seshadri Chari, am I wrong in that?
No, you are not. You are absolutely right on that. I think the Congress party is very indecisive about this whole issue on Sri Lanka. In the first place, they have not yet been able to decide whether what they did last year in voting with the resolution was correct or not. If that was correct, there is no reason why they are now taking a very different position as of this particular vote is concerned, and they are still not able to decide whether they should either vote or not vote or abstain. That is why I again suggested yesterday and I am again suggesting today, if you are not decided whether to vote in favor or against, it is better to abstain so that the future does not blame you just because you voted last time, number one. Number two, the Congress's position is not in keeping with the government's position on this. We should differentiate between the Congress party and the government. The government of India is solely responsible for taking actions and decisions and follow-up as far as external affairs ministry's views are concerned. The government of India should not take any action which it is forced to take by virtue of the political dimensions of the state.
Yes.
Which raises these issues.
No, my point is
our action vis-a-vis Bangladesh.
Yes.
In Bangladesh, we made a mess of the whole issue by not taking into cognizance the views of the local chief minister.
With you.
The chief minister of West Bengal.
With you on it. I'm with you on it.
So we cannot allow the foreign policy of this country to be decided by the politics that is going on in.
Who's doing the politics? Who is doing the politics? You walked out with the DMK today. Are they not doing politics? Has the DMK not constantly changed its position as well? Mr. Elangovan, has the DMK not changed its position every time?
We have never changed our position so far.
You changed your position.
DMK has also changed its position.
We have never changed our position.
Mr. Elangovan, Mr. Seshadri Chari of the BJP today is telling you, and I want you to hear him, why he feels that your party is also changing its position. Yes, Mr. Chari, first, what would you like to say to Mr. Elangovan?
We have not changed our position. We are with the Sri Lanka Tamils
from
the beginning, not only now.
No.
It had started, I will tell you, there is a long history which you might not have known. See, we are with the Sri Lankan Tamils since 1956, even much earlier. When in 1948, a resolution in the Sinhala Sri Lankan Assembly, then it was Ceylon. Ceylon Parliament was passed that resolution was called Sinhala only resolution.
No.
Since then we were opposed to the Sri Lankan Ceylonese government and we were with the Tamils since then.
Sir, let me assure you.
We have never changed our position.
Let me remind you. Let me remind you that in July 2009, allow me, sir. Mr. Elangovan, allow me.
Yes.
In July 2009.
Yes, tell me.
Karunanidhi, your supreme leader, distancing himself from the demand of the AIDMK and the PMK that Sri Lanka President Mahinda Rajapakse should be hauled up for war crimes, your chief minister, Karunanidhi, said it would be an exercise in futility as it will only adversely affect the safety of Tamils in the country. This is what Karunanidhi said, sir. Today you change your position.
That shows our consistency. That shows our consistency that we are with the people, Tamils of Sri Lanka. That we don't want the Tamils of Sri Lanka to be put into hardship.
Sir,
that is your consistency.
Sir, how come you realize BBC Sinhala in July 2009 has reported that Karunanidhi said that calls for an investigation into the endgame of the civil war on the grounds that it would be counterproductive to reconciliation. I have it on record. That your chief minister, am I wrong, Mr. Rajagopal? Your chief minister said there is no need for an investigation
into
the end game. Mr. Rajagopal.
DMK
is playing politics, Arnab. DMK is having one state. When they are chief minister, they say one. When they are in opposition, they speak different voice. DMK speaks in two voices. Today they came to Delhi and the TESO conference is a major flop. Mulayam Singh Yadav did not go. Lalu Prasad Yadav did not go, but suddenly Congress surfaced in that meeting. No success of TESO conference in Delhi. Therefore, DMK is playing twin politics, double politics, They continue to be in power, but still they want to take the flesh out of the Congress
conference
and also UP.
Is a success or not is not the question. Can you say that we have ever stood against the Sri Lankan Tamils?
Achha, Arunabh,
can you say at
Mr.
any
Manek
point
Thakur,
of time
why
we were against,
they have gone to
we were not
supporter.
In the, no, our
till today Congress never supported Elam, but today Congress joined in Teso conference.
Can you
there is a complete
say,
contradiction between Congress and DMK. It's a Tamil
a
politics.
It is not, no, it is, we did not say that during a war, killing of innocent people is a normal thing. We did not say such things. We were always stood by the side of the Sri Lankan Tamils, and we continue to do. We have been doing this for more than 40
why
years.
Why suddenly Karunanidhi withdrew the fast? When he
that.
Was on a hunger strike, suddenly why did he go withdraw the fast? Because he says Sri
See,
Lankan government misled
the
him.
Of the government
where was his
of India?
Intelligence?
It was
what
on
is
the
DMK MPs doing
of,
to tell Karunanidhi?
It was on the promise made by the Sri Lankan government to the government of India that he withdrew the support. It is all on record. We are not playing
that
politics.
Means the government
we
of
don't
India
want to
misled
play
DMK leader Karunanidhi. Is it so?
Sri Lanka. We have never.
Do
we
you
are not Jayalalitha. We are not
ADMK
to say stance. We have never changed our stance until date.
No, and let's be clear.
We have changed the stance. No, you may use certain statements against us, but that doesn't mean that we have changed our stance. We are
Arunabh Karunanidhi, when he is chief minister, he speaks something. When he is in opposition in Tamil Nadu, he speaks something.
No,
when in Delhi,
called,
he speaks
called,
something.
You called
today
something.
Today in Teso conference, which, totally topical
You called
topic
something
that.
Which is, he has spoken against the Sri Lankan Tamils. My question is, can you quote anything which he has spoken against the Sri Lankan Tamils? Taking a stand
why
against
did he
the
withdraw
the
past then? He should have continued.
Sri Lankan Tamils.
And he should have pressurized the central
I can
government
quote
that the Tamils should not be
which
killed.
The ADMK did.
Gentlemen, I want to get in at this stage, Dr. Naganathan of youth.org. My simple question tonight is this, and this is why we are debating Brits right on top of News Hour. It is important for any country to look at its strategic interests when it is taking a decision at the United Nations. We have a choice. We can anger Sri Lanka.
Arnab.
We can, 1 minute.
Arnab.
I'm putting this for the viewer. We can anger Sri Lanka and take them on. But first, we have to look within and ask ourselves if all the political parties in India today are doing politics before a general election. Whether they have been consistent is a question I'm just putting
out. No, not so.
Yes, Dr. Naganathan.
See, today it's very clear the entire Indian parliament, the Congress was a minority. An entire Indian parliament came together and vouched for an international independent war crime investigations, and they pressurized for a draft to be forwarded by India, not by some external affairs country outside. India should lead the championship of human justice as it did. India is a country which stands for right to self-determination. India is a country which stood for PLO, Palestine crisis. India is a country which stood for Southern Sudan. So India should take the same stand in Sri Lanka.
Why should we? Let me play devil's
because
advocate.
India,
no, why should we be the only country in South Asia to vote against Sri Lanka? Why should we estrange ourselves from our South Asian neighbors? This is a huge strategic implication that this is going to have.
Because you can't bypass the sentiments of 6 crore Indian Tamils in Tamil Nadu.
What about the sentiments? What about the sentiments?
We are Indian citizens.
What about the sentiments of a billion Indians? 1 minute. What about the sentiments of a billion Indians, including everyone in Tamil Nadu? 1 minute. Against the assassination of Rajiv Gandhi.
Yes. Why you are taking each time the discussion to Rajiv Gandhi's assassination? 2009 to 2012, 140,000 Tamil people have been massacred. You're not talking about that. UN panel report says 40,000 Tamil have been massacred. You're not
and
talking about
UPA
that.
UPA government was
you
a spectator to that.
The war of
then UPA government was a spectator to the killings of Tamil Nadu, Tamil peoples in Sri Lanka. Why should not DMK raise that?
You have raised that.
UPA will not support Sri Lanka. I'm telling you, in UPA will definitely go with Rajapakse and they will go against Tamils. That is the impression almost all political parties in Tamil Nadu have that.
Mr. Manek Tagar, would you like to respond 3 times tonight on the program? 3 times. Mr. Rajagopal has questioned you and your party and your position and your inconsistency. Respond to him.
Mr. Arunab, you need to give me time because I have to respond three things. One is, I was totally taken back from 1 year before when we had the resolution for the same time again in the UNHRC. BJP was not walking out of that parliament. BJP was taking a U-turn. BJP has playing into a new role. BJP's chief minister welcomed Rajapakse to Sanchi in Madhya Pradesh. We were in the trip to Sushma Swaraji when she was leading the trip to Sri Lanka. She invited them to be in Sanchi. Now Yashwant Sinha is speaking a different language. Why BJP is taking a U-turn? I don't know. What is the problem with them? Why
they, answer that, Mr. Chari.
Walked out in the previous year when it was going for a vote. One. Second is that Congress is very consistent. Congress stood for the Tamils in Sri Lanka and it stands for it, and we are for the Tamils in Sri Lanka and a good relation with Sri Lanka. We are for a unified Sri Lanka and equal citizens as Tamils and Sinhalese to live together, and we want justice to those Tamils who have lost their lives there. That's our point number two. And against Mr. Rajagopal's view, he always speaks for Ms. Jayalalitha's view. And he speaks a different language.
I
can't be responsible for his language. And I am very clear that
been elected.
He as congressman,
he has been elected
Tamil
by Tamil
Congress.
People. Congress has been routed in Tamil Nadu. Don't say that.
Who are you to say that we are being routed? Who are you to say we?
Are you going to support
Mr. Rajagopal
tomorrow?
Mr. Rajagopal.
Congress has come out very clean on that.
Who are you to say the thing that you have been routed? We are not routed. Everybody, Jayalalitha was also, your friend Jayalalitha also has been routed in Tamil Nadu. Don't say like that. Elections we win and elections are fought in different issues.
Tomorrow when Teso announces Tamil Nadu band, will Congress join the band?
You
tell me that, that's all. Whether I am Jayalalitha or Karunanidhi, leave alone that.
You
are talking about BJP.
They
are not at all in the picture. Why do you come into the picture about DMK?
Don't speak like this.
That's the problem with Sri Lankan crisis right now.
For BJP, you speak for yourself.
Dr. Naganathan wants to respond to you.
One minute.
Also, another point was raised. Calm down. Calm down, gentlemen. Calm down 1 minute. Please, 1 minute. 1 minute, gentlemen.
Arunab, you gave me chance.
I give you the chance, but just be patient for a minute. Mr. Manik Thakur
is allowing me to speak.
Mr. Manik Thakur has a right to speak. 1 minute. Mr. Manik Thakur, the second point which you raised needs a response from Seshadri Chari. Because you as a Congress representative have directly accused the BJP of double games and hypocrisy. You said that Sushma Swaraj was very good with Mr. Rajapakse, that she met him. You have said they invited him to Madhya Pradesh for a religious function and they are doing duplicity. Seshadri Chari, prepare to answer that. Before that, Dr. Naganathan wanted to respond to what Manik Thakur said. Yes, Dr. Naganathan, what would you say to the Congress MP?
Simple. See, this Tamil Eelam crisis or Tamil Sri Lanka Tamil crisis has always been in the plight of politics. In Tamil Nadu, it is ADMK and DMK politics. In the center, it is Congress and BJP politics. They don't have a very clear-cut strategy on who is to blame. The Congress, I say, what happened to the Congress promises of 13th Amendment? The Sri Lanka has thrown to dustbin. What follow-up that the Congress has for the follow-up?
Answer that.
Rajapaksa has denied any type of federal solution. They
answer
threw
that.
The Rajiv Gandhi Lankan Accord into the dustbin.
Answer that. Why have you been spectators to the marginalization
plus.
Of the Tamils in Sri Lanka?
13th plus amendment.
Answer that, Manik Thakur. Why have you been spectators to the marginalization of Tamils in Sri Lanka?
Very good question. We are very clear about it. 13th amendment, whenever Rajapakse has been met, President Rajapakse has been met, he has been told that 13th amendment implementation is the topmost for us. And we had been pressurizing them and we will be continuing.
Now in the recent Independence Day speech.
Prime Minister.
Kindly.
Now, in his recent Independence Day speech, Rajapakse told that please. 13th Amendment is a failure.
Please hear me. Please give me a minute.
He can't adopt any type of federal solution.
Story. 13th Amendment is a major importance in the power sharing for the Tamils and Sinhalese. Single people.
Don't talk about the 13th Amendment. The Sri Lankan court
government has been very clear in it that we should be, the Tamil should be given equal rights, and we are pressurizing that there should be an elected government. There is in the eastern province there is an elected government, and
Rajapakse
elected government. We want to have. We are using.
Let me respond.
Extreme,
respond.
We are pressurizing all the
5 minutes left into the debate. Respond, please.
Let me respond.
Yes, please go ahead.
Let me respond. Rajapakse, in his recent independence speech, told that any type of federal solution is ruled out. Sri Lankan Supreme Court has clearly struck down the 13th Amendment, stating it is null and void. They clearly said that we don't follow any type of federal solutions to be imported from any country. They have thrown out the Indo-Lanka record. They have insulted Rajiv Gandhi Jayavardhane Pact and threw into dustbin. And each time the Prime Minister will say 13th Amendment, the next time Prime Minister will 13 plus. There's no more 13 or no more 13 plus. They said that in Unity Constitution, we won't give any type of provincial or autonomy to Tamils. That's the stand of Sri Lanka. What did Congress did to pressurize Sri Lanka in order to... for these type of statements?
He's absolutely right, Manik Tagore. Let's put the fact right. The fact is Rajapakse government made a commitment to India. It made a commitment to the Indian people about implementation of 13th Amendment in letter and spirit. It told us we will devolve powers, especially in the Tamil-dominated north of the country. Now, this minister, Vimal Veerasinghe, has written to President Rajapakse requesting a referendum to repeal the constitutional provision. You are being challenged on the News Hour tonight. Why have you been quiet about it? Today, you can do politics. You are doing politics before a general election, Mr. Tagore.
No, not at all, Mr. Arunav. It is very clear that we are very clear on 13th Amendment and sharing of power for the Tamils and Sri Lankans, single is there. We had been, our Prime Minister, when Rajapakse met, Prime Ministers were very clear. Today also, when the Foreign Minister was replying, he was very clear on the 13th Amendment, and the Government of India is very, 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 very clear.
Some of the Sri Lankans have been bluffing us.
13th
In a recent newspaper interview, two days back, Rajapakse very clearly said that 13th Amendment is a failure.
We have to understand. You can't go on the newspaper reports when the head of the state meets the another.
3 minutes
state,
into the debate.
No, it was Rajapakse's interview.
Three minutes to go.
Don't worry about it. We will not leave.
Three minutes to go. Response from the BJP.
What are you going to do? We will not leave. What are you going to do?
Why Congress is supporting Elam? Till today they did not support.
Response.
Why did they start supporting today?
I want the BJP representative now to be allowed to come in, please. My question to the BJP representative is Seshadri Chari. Quite clearly, you have been accused directly by the Congress of hypocrisy vis-a-vis Mahinda Rajapakse. Respond directly to that charge.
Arnav, I think it is very important to look at Sri Lanka issue from the point of view of Indo-Sri Lanka relations and Hindu-Buddhist relations and Tamil-Sinhali relations.
Hindu-Buddhist, okay.
And this kind of a setup which we are having now, the kind of tempers that are running high in your channel right now, this is not the right time to go into so much of history. Two points were made against BJP. One, the BJP has changed its position.
Yeah.
BJP has not changed its position vis-a-vis the interest of Tamil population, the Tamil-speaking population, in north and east of Sri Lanka. There has been a lot of misgiving about the political situation there. I have visited Sri Lanka and I am constantly in touch with TNA. In a recent election, the TNA virtually swept the polls. And today the chief minister of the northern province is a Tamilian, and there are a number of political heavyweights who are ruling that place.
But Seshadri,
and they have also got equal representation in the Colombo political situation. But when it comes to 13th Amendment and when it comes to devolution of power, listen. I have some more things to answer. Somebody pointed out about inviting Rajapakshe
to Madhya Pradesh.
Sanchi.
Yeah.
This history goes back to 150 years.
So what about the recent history?
150th birth anniversary.
What about the recent history?
Please listen to me now. Please listen to me. 150 years back, Swami Vivekananda spoke in Parliament of Religions in Chicago. There were two people in that conference who spoke. One was
there is 1500 years relationship between us and Tamils.
And these 1500 years of relationship and these 150 years of relationship have all fructified in that conference which was held in Sanchi, which was called Dhamma Dharma Conference. And I am very glad that DMK, after all, has also changed its position.
Change.
Going by what? I am very happy.
Mr.
Happy, I am saying.
If there is a change of heart
in the DMK. I am glad that Mr. T.R. Balu mentioned about 467 Hindu temples being destroyed in the Tamil province. I want Mr. T.R. Balu to raise this issue. I want Mr. T.R. Balu to raise this issue. And he has raised this issue, and Government of India also should raise this issue with Colombo.
Mr. Elangovan, the last response
therefore,
is yours on this news article tonight.
Allow Colombo.
My question to you is,
We cannot allow Colombo.
One second, Mr. Elangovan,
We cannot allow Colombo to walk away with all these things.
Yes, two things.
But at the same time, we cannot destroy our relations with Sri Lanka.
Understood.
Which is in a very strategic position in the Indian Ocean region.
One second. Last two points to Mr. Elangovan. Mr. Rajagopal, 1 minute, gentlemen.
Let me respond.
One minute, gentlemen. Mr. Rajagopal, I clearly see you want to say something. You want to say something before I give the last word. My question.
I want to ask Mr. Manek Thakur, why suddenly they started to support Elam, the word Elam, Teso conference, why they attended today? Till now, the Congress has been saying, don't
join. You have made that point,
Teso,
sir.
Number one. Number two, will Congress, Tamil Nadu Congress, join Teso strike in Tamil Nadu day after tomorrow? Will Congress join that?
Okay, you made that point. I think he's answered that before. The question to Mr. Elangovan is this. Mr. Elangovan, at the end of the day, a lot of people believe regional parties cannot decide foreign policy of a country. Today, a party in Assam cannot decide for its interest what the foreign policy of the country should be. A party in Bengal cannot decide. A party in Tamil Nadu cannot decide.
I don't know. Whatever I know is that the regional party in Bengal decided the foreign policy of our nation, our country. That is why Bangladesh is in existence. Don't say that a regional party cannot formulate the foreign policy of this country. We had seen. We are not bothered about how a policy is evolved or something. We want the Tamils in the island to be safe with equal rights. We are bothered about the Tamils who are being killed unnecessarily, the innocent Tamils being killed. And we are bothered about the genocide that is happening. Any human being can question about this.
Sir, then why did you...
It not be in the foreign policy
why
or
did,
not.
Sir, then, sir, your point is correct. You're right. But I don't understand then why your party took that position on the 2nd of July 2009 when your chief minister distanced himself from the demand that Jayalalitha put, and Manik Tagore will be angry, but it was Jayalalitha who put the demand that Rajapakse should be hauled up for war crimes. Jayalalitha put that demand. You have to...
I don't want... Jayalalitha is the only person in the entire world who said there is nothing wrong. It happens that whenever during war, innocent people are killed.
No, she said,
Jayalalitha has no consistent stand.
She said...
She will always play sentimental politics. She will always
but
play
she's been consistent on this
which,
one.
She will always say something which is impractical. She will always
when, then why are you following her?
Something which cannot be carried out.
Well, then why are you following her? You are following what she said.
Forget about Jayalalitha. Jayalalitha is no issue. She has nothing. She is, in fact, she is the friend of Rajapakse.
Gentlemen, that question goes up. Did the DMK follow Jayalalitha? Has the Congress changed its position? Is the BJP consistent? And what is the DMK up to? However, whichever way you look at it, what happens in the way we vote will determine a lot, not just in our strategic affairs, but in our national politics. In a pre-election year, many parties change their position. This is not the first time. Thanks for joining me on debate number one on the NewsHour tonight.